Hey guys, welcome to another video, and are you tired of losing from Child? Does he beat you? Does he one punch you like he's the One Punch Man boss Boruus? Yeah, then stick around guys, because in this video I'm going over all the mechanics on how to dodge them, how to counter them, and how to beat the shit out of him like One Punch Man himself. So guys, without further ado, let's get into the guide and I'm gonna teach you how to beat him easy mode. Let's go! The moment the fight starts, he will immediately fire 4 arrows at you. Be on the lookout for this animation and get ready to dodge. If you get hit by one of his attacks, you will get this debuff. You need to be careful when you have this debuff, because once you get hit by a second hit, you will take serious damage and probably die immediately. Immediately after attacking him the first time, he will have a counter ready, and it looks like this. So make sure you dodge immediately after. The moment you see him aim the bow upwards, he's gonna shoot some arrows from the sky, but they are simply dodgeable by just running around in circles, like so. And right after dodging the arrows, he will be open up for a short window to attack, but be careful, he will have the counter attack up as well. Once he teleports backwards and is taunting you, it's a moment we are looking for, because that is a moment we can actually deal out a serious amount of damage. Here we can flinch him by breaking his super armor. And once you broke his super armor, you can interrupt his attack, like so. And once that has happened, you can basically bash him down to phase 2. But what can also happen is that he will have his counter armor. That means we didn't do enough damage and the super armor is still available. You can break this by doing a fire attack or lightning attack, and you will have the same state. You can flinch him, bash him up, down to phase 2. Phase 2 is pretty easy. He is a lightning character, so it's recommended to bring a fire character, and I will tell you why a bit later. But he will start the fight with a dash attack. Once you see this pose, he will start the dash attack. He can either do a single dash or a triple dash, and he can do that later in the fight as well. If he does a single dash, he will follow up with a charge attack followed by an attack, so make sure you dodge at the correct time. In this phase, he has super armor as well, like in the first phase. So once you see this super armor on top of him, like so, make sure you do a couple hits to lower down his super armor rating. And be ready to dodge the moment you attack him while his super armor is up, because he will counterattack. When you hear him say the sentence, he will start doing his most annoying attack, which will probably one-shot you. So once you have this debuff and you hear him say that, attack him with a fire attack or break his super armor. Just like so. And that is why it's very important to lower his super armor whenever you can. Once you see him spinning his sword like this, make sure you dodge behind him and start dishing out some damage. And once you have him flinched, after you've done enough damage to super armor, you just hammer him down just like in phase 1. I recommend you bringing a fire character and an electro character just to have enough elemental reactions. For example, like overload, so you can break a super armor quicker, just so you can flinch him a bit faster and you can dish out more damage. Alright guys, let's move on to the final phase. And let me teach you some tricks on how to actually beat this guy very easy, so you're able to dodge all his attacks and he cannot harm you in any single way. So let's teach this wannabe Boruus some lesson on who's the boss. Unlike the first two phases, his basic attack patterns in this phase are very easy to dodge. They are very telegraphed, so therefore they're pretty easy to dodge. As you can see in the clip right now, make sure you always dodge behind him, just so you can deal out some extra bits of damage. And remember, dodging is more important than damage in this phase, because once you get hit by the debuff, like I explained in phase 1, if you get that second hit, you will instantly die. After you see him do this combo and he slashes with both swords at the same time and across, do not think he's ready with attacking, because he will follow up with a very nasty attack, so be ready to dodge. The moment you see him teleport, he will either do two things. He will do this wave attack, or he will charge attack you from range. So the moment you see him disappear, stop attacking and be ready to dodge, just like so. He will also do these types of attacks while being in long range from him. So just pay close attention to his animations and you'll be fine. There is one other move he will do while being in range, and that is shooting arrows. He can either shoot a single arrow or multiple arrows. Just look at his animations to determine if you need to keep dodging. The moment you see him seat the sword, you can start going in for the damage. Now let's move on to his three most annoying attacks. First up is his well attack. It's basically MiHoYo saying you need to be a well to have this guy being OP. So there's the hidden message from MiHoYo for you. But yeah, to dodge this one, it's very simple. So you just wait for Dollars to come out of the ground. And once he's out of the ground, you just walk up straight to Child and start attacking him just like so. This next one is very easy to dodge as well. You just wait for him to point his arrow up to the sky, just like so. And you just walk to the center of the map. That's all there is to it. Always walk to the center of the map. It's always the same. Once that's happened, we get ready for the next most annoying attack. And you can always be ready for that, because he will always do these three following attacks in a row. Well, arrows into this lightning spear attack from the sky. Now let me show you how to actually dodge this lightning spear, which is probably the most annoying attack you've encountered so far. Alright, there's three ways we can dodge this attack, so let's go over all of them. And no, you cannot use your dodge skill to dodge this attack. You have to use a special technique to dodge it. I will go from most difficult to the most easy one. So let's start with the most difficult one, and that is an iframe the moment you get your debuff applied, as you can see right here. Which makes him so he will do the attack in the center of the map instead of on you. But this one is way too difficult to pull off, so let's move on to some easier ways to do it. The second one is using your ultimate iframe the moment you get hit by the attack. Let me show you how it's done. Alright, as you can see, the ultimate works very nicely. But what do you do when you do not have an ult available? Well, let's move on to the final trick, and that is basically getting an elemental reaction with the debuff. So the easiest way to achieve this is by getting the pyro debuff. And funny enough, on the edge of the field, in case you didn't realize it, you will get a pyro debuff. So all you have to do basically is walk to the edge of the field just like so. And that's why this trick is the easiest to do. So that is basically the best way to dodge this attack. And I recommend using this all the time. If for some reason you cannot make it to the edge of the map, you can always use your ultimate as a backup. Now you just keep repeating through these motions until you lower its HP all the way down to zero and you finally beat him. Alright, I hope this was helpful to y'all. I hope I gave you enough tools to be able to beat him yourself. And hopefully you learned something new that you can apply in your own gameplay. If you have any questions, be sure to drop a comment down below. Or you're more than welcome to join my stream if you need some help with your content, you want to clear a dungeon. I'm trying to stream at least a couple times a week. And I always try to help my viewers out with any content they require. So be sure to check it out. If this was helpful to you, then be sure to hit that subscribe button and like this video. That way you will be notified when I stream to help you guys, or if I drop a new video with a new guide. So I hope I helped some people with this video. You can continue watching this video, what you can do when you have enough damage, or you can just quit right now. I'm gonna already thank you guys for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video. This was Taichobob, peace out.